on every nigga trying to see things. We bout money, had a neighborhood bling bling, and kick back and blow out the fat sack. You won't stun every ghetto nigga bout that. Around the world, every nigga trying to see things. We bout money, had a neighborhood bling bling, and kick back and blow out the fat sack. Yeah, nigga, you won't stun every ghetto nigga bout that. The little homie came through in a new range. He doing too much, the little nigga moving things. He doing the rush with real niggas getting changed. He posted up the neighborhood fast lane. From Sunday night, a nigga trying to get it right. And gunfire make a nigga understand life. You lose your life, you pay the price. The homie wasn't strapped, so a nigga got him last night. Another situation, homie got a pipeline. The block wide open till we see the sunshine. And we was taught never let a nigga stop the grind. And come through the neighborhood, disrespect mine. Now mama was a beast, ran hard in these streets. She gotta eat and she hustled 7 days a week. She want a ball with 23s on a Jeep. She got busted, now she right back on the street. Around the world, every nigga tryna see things. We bout money, had a neighborhood bling bling, and kick back and blow out the fat sack. You won't stun every ghetto nigga bout that. Around the world, every nigga tryna see things. We bout money, had a neighborhood bling bling, and kick back and blow out
get
the fat sack.
Get your roll on, nigga.
You won't stun every ghetto nigga.
The shit is whack, a nigga won't back change. I can't get a phone call, nigga playing games. But when I catch up, a nigga gon' bust his brains. Make a family grieve, make a nigga feel pain. Another issue, Patricia is the real thing. I pray every day, big mama do a thing. She got a Benz and I bought a new pinky ring. She got a house on the hill, mama bling bling. My homie Bryce just came home last night. And best believe a nigga put it in his life. You wanna see, so check out the loud pipes. And Malin cool, his neck and wrists alright. Another thing, a nigga wanna hate a man. And fuck around and hit a nigga with that bang bang. The Birdman bout making money fucking hoes. Tryna get $1 million up in one roll.
Around the world, every nigga tryna see things. We bout money, had a neighborhood bling bling, and kick back and blow out the fat sack. You won't stun every ghetto nigga bout that. Around the world, every nigga tryna see things. We bout money, had a neighborhood bling bling, and kick back and blow out the fat sack. You won't stun every ghetto nigga bout that.
My homie Kevin just did 10 in a pen. Ain't been home 6 months in a new pen. Stepping on the grind, trying to see the sunshine. Taught us all young how to hustle, stay shy. And KC won the realest of the
real. Yeah. Rizzo, the motherfucking hero, baby. What's going on with you, yo? Oh, man. Check it out, man. I am here live in motherfucking Inglewood. The real niggas are up for no good. Yes, man. Right in front of my fucking job right now, man. You heard me? Shout out to the Sci-Fi Stadium. For those of y'all who don't know, this is where all the games take place. All the NFL games and shit. Shout out to the motherfucking Rams. But at the end of the day, it's about the motherfucking Saints. All about that black and gold, huh? I got the black on to represent, bitch. You know what I'm saying? Matter of fact, I'm going to tell y'all what's so cool. They actually have two. You got the Kai Stadium right here. They got concerts that go on here. And they got this, like, right next door. Like, God, just like New Orleans, huh? Yeah, the fucking Superdome of the goddamn New Orleans Arena. Ain't that a bitch? Tell you, boy, no matter where you go, you see the same hoe. Yes, you do. But anyway, though, man, check it out. I wanted to come at y'all today on some real shit, though, dude. Let me tell you something. And this is for everyone. I don't care if you're an atheist. I don't care if you believe in God or not. Well, actually, I do. Because as a man of God, it's actually my job to enhance you to live like me. When you have God in your life, you may be temporarily lost. You know what I'm saying? Temporary. But you are never alone. You understand? Shout out to the best mother in the world, Mrs. Angel McGee. Hey, mom, what's going on, baby? There are things in this world to where there are moves that has to be made. There are decisions that has to be made. You know what I'm saying? To where it's us as human beings, we're not going to know the answer. We're going to be hesitant. We're always going to be like, shit, should I move here? Should I take this job? Should I quit this job? Should I leave this relationship? This thing that's offered to me, is it really an opportunity? Or is it a fraud? Is it a screw over? You know what I'm saying? All these things we deal with. And yes, this shit does stress us out. You know what I'm saying? Especially as adults, especially for some of you who have children, who can't just up and make any type of decision at the end of the day. People, let me tell you something. And my mother has always told me this. Anything that hits you like that, you know what I'm saying, is like I tell people this. Go back to the video I did a few weeks ago as far as cash out, cop out. You know what I mean? Sometimes we just don't know. All you have to do, man, is just ask for God to guide you. That's it. You know what I'm saying? God knows that you're a human being. He created you. He know what you are. All of those things that you're faced with, all those things that's brought upon you, all that you have on your plate, he put it there. Not the ones that are not good, the things that don't represent him, but all of those decisions. There are some things in life, man, where you're going to have to take a chance. You're going to have to take a chance on. There are some things in life you're going to have to take a risk on. You understand? You're going to get played. you're going to get cheated. You know what I'm saying? You may get even mistreated in some situations. But I tell this to anyone, it's the difference between letting someone mistreat you and being tricked or being manipulated or being misled. Because that was something that you know, you didn't see coming. That was something that just happened. But when you're being misused, you know good and goddamn well when you're being misused. You know how that shit feel. You know you don't like the way that feels. Understand? But at some point in life, people, some point in life, you have a parachute. At some point, people, at some point, you are going to have to jump. You are going to have to jump to see if your parachute's open. If you have God with you, your parachute will open. You may not land where you want to land. You may not land where you was expecting to land. But your parachute will open. You will not fall and fail. And just, without God, you will. You know what I'm saying? But at the end of the day, that's what I'm talking about. There are some things in this world, people, whereas you need answers to. In order for you to have answers, you have to make that fucking move. You understand? You can't just sit there as some shoulda, woulda, coulda. Oh, I wonder what happened if I woulda did this. I wonder what happened if I'd have did that. You understand? I wonder what happened if I'd have just took a chance on that. Every goddamn day, every day. So the reason why it's so important, because it give you answers. It's, like I say, it's going to give you answers that you won't have to worry about later on down the road asking your fucking self. You know, if I'd have done that, you understand? People, let me tell you something. There are relationships. It's like I told y'all motherfuckers, I ain't never been dumb. I'm not bragging and trying to sound all Billy badass like a fucking Mac Daddy player. But me, myself, every relationship that I was in, I ended it. I made that decision. You understand? I never cheated. That's the reason I don't cheat, because I'd rather just fucking leave your ass and leave you lost. Me, the kind of man I am, I don't think about, oh, well, what if I would have took a chance and did something that I wanted to do? You understand? I've been doing what I've pretty, not gonna say everything I wanted to do, but the majority of the things since I've been a man, I have been pursuing, and I'm proud of myself for that. I give myself a pat on the back for that, because there's a lot of people from my community who hasn't done that. Not saying that I'm better than them, but they're probably in certain situations or under certain circumstances to where they can't just do that. You understand? So that's why when the opportunity comes or the opportunity knocks, fuck opening the door. You need to kick that bitch down. I'll tell you something else was so good about being in that situation. When it comes to life, it's always good to ask yourself to really not even ask yourself, but to just think, damn, I wonder if I didn't leave that situation that was making me uncomfortable. I wonder if I'd have stayed in that same environment where I was being unappreciated. You know what I'm saying? It's good to just look back and look down and be like, damn, I'm glad I'm not there. Or damn, I'm glad I didn't make the decision. I'm glad I didn't do something that would have kept me in that situation. You understand? Instead of years later, you gotta look up and be like, I wonder how would it if I took that opportunity. I wonder, that could have been me up there. That could have been me on that platform. That could have been me that had all that money and had this and that. You don't want to be that. You understand? So I'm grateful to God for that. I'm grateful. Every last one of us, that's why I tell people, it's not a thing to where some people in this world, they're just, it's sad, especially as an adult. It's like I said, I understand if you have children, you know what I mean? You have to be considerate of your children and your family. And if you're in a serious relationship, you're married with someone, you know, it's a partnership. But everyone pursues something that they want. You understand? Whether it's a person that you want to date, whether it's a job that you want, whether it's a place that you want to go, everyone pursues something they want. You understand? The thing is that for those who don't pursue the things that are more beneficial and more relevant in the long run, what you do is that you look at those who did and you hate on them. You get jealous of them. You envy them. You understand? You have the same fucking airplane, bitch. Don't be fucking disturbing me while I'm... All because that person take a chance. All because that person took a chance. All because that person jumped and your scary ass didn't. You stayed up there, wherever you was at. Your parachute never opened. You never found out. As a man now, yeah, I do. I look back at all the fucking relationships I was in, and it's like, wow, I wonder if I would have stayed with them bitches. I wonder if I'd have let them bitches kept having that fucking control over me. If I'd have just kept letting them play them fucking games. If I'd have just let them manipulate me, trying to bullshit me. You understand? It feels better. I'd rather be in this situation I am now than to be married to one of them bitches. You understand? Damn, I wonder how my life would be as a single man. I wonder all the pussy that I'm out there, I'm passing up out there. All the fucking women out there who really love me. And some of you men who are married, you are in that situation. You understand? Thank God for the best sister in the world. You're Anita motherfucking Lavender. You understand? AKA DJ Yacht. AKA the founder of motherfucking Yacht Creation. You heard me? My twin sister, my baby. But ever since we was little kids, my sister was the only relative, the only person in the world who kept saying, boy, when you get to California, my sister would always look at me. acting ass, you know, around the house and, you know, making her laugh, her and my mom and shit like that, and be like, boy, will you make it to California? Boy, will you make it to Hollywood? Will you make it to California? For those of you who fuck with me, who've been following me for a long time, y'all know what it was, man. I jumped on a fucking Amtrak train to do with $150. You understand? No family out here in California. No one who I knew. No friends. Nothing. It was just something that I wanted to do for my goddamn self. You understand? And I'm glad I'm not dissing nobody from New Orleans. And all of you niggas who's taking this shit personal, fuck you. Because you ain't nothing but a hater. But at the end of the day, I'm glad. I'm not one of them niggas that's fucking stuck in New Orleans talking about some goddamn, oh, I wonder someday I'm going to be out there. Oh, you know what? Someday I'm going to take it out. Some, you know, I wonder if I'd ever know. You understand? I ain't got time for that shit. Every day that we live, we wake up. If y'all can't see that all this shit is coming to an end soon, something is wrong with you. And I'm not trying to scare any children. I'm not trying to scare any minors. I'm not trying to discourage anyone from following their dreams or following their goal or pursuing anything. But I'm just saying, I'm telling you, we don't have enough time. We have time. We have time to chase happiness. We have time to be successful, but we don't have time to fucking procrastinate. We don't have time to hesitate. We don't have time to sit there and fucking wonder, I wonder. No, you understand? God give you signs for a reason. He give you certain opportunities for a reason. He put certain things in your mind for a reason. So that's why I say, if you have him in your life, you ain't never lost. You understand? You will jump. You may not land where you was expecting to land. And let me tell you something. Be grateful to God. Be grateful to God for not giving you what you thought you wanted in this world. You understand? I think about jobs. Like, damn, I wonder if I'd have stayed there and just stayed a goddamn slave and just continue letting them take advantage of me, paying me pennies and shit like that, knowing I wasn't gonna never move up. I wasn't gonna never be manager. I wasn't gonna never be supervisor. I wasn't gonna never get no fucking raise. You understand? They wasn't gonna never do nothing to enhance my career. They wasn't gonna never help me to go to school or sponsor this program or school, whatever, to help me as a person. You understand? So it's like I say, yeah, I'm not rich. I'm not famous. You understand? But guess what? I still got my motherfucking soul. I still have my integrity. And most of all, I'm still alive, which means I'm still able to do the things that I need to do or want to do or pursue in this world. You understand? So at the end of the day, though, man, I'm going to leave it with that. And never be afraid to jump. God put you at the top and he put a parachute on your ass for a reason, not to just stay there and waste your goddamn parachute. You understand? God is with you. You may be lost, baby, but you ain't never alone. Rizzo the hero, man. Later, peace. Look, that's how y'all know it's time. See? Coincidence, man. I'm talking about going places in life, and it's just like the third airplane. I'm tired of fucking with y'all. If y'all can't see the signs, y'all too goddamn stupid. Rizzo the hero, man. Later, peace. I'm gonna tell y'all something too. Let me tell y'all something. We have so-called family, so-called friends, so-called associates, so-called whoever that sit there, and when you're thinking about doing something, they say something about it that's negative. You understand? Yeah, okay, I understand that some people may try to, you know, be like, well, you need to live in reality. Well, you know, it is what it, well, look, you know, this is not for you. Look, you know, you're getting older and this and this and that. People, at the end of the day, like I said, God gave you the vision, not them. You understand? It's like I say, you know, some of us, we have husbands, wives, we have children, you know, and being in a relationship, that's why I say, dude, I'm with me being out here in California, dude, I feel as if I owe it to myself to not even get into a serious fucking relationship. Not just because 99.9% of the women out here in California are fucking hoes and trash, you understand? I'm not trying to sound rude, but I'm just saying. But at the end of the day, though, man, he didn't bring me out here with no wife, you understand? He didn't bring me out here with no children. You know what I'm saying? He didn't bring me out here with no girlfriend. I didn't even come out. I don't even have no fucking family out here. You know what I'm saying? And if I do at the end of the day, fuck them, because they ain't got in touch with me. And I don't know them anyway. So at the end of the day, I don't have time for that. And that's what I'm trying to tell you. You don't have time either. It's you by yourself. And as a man, you already know no one is coming to save you. No one is going to have sympathy for you. You don't follow your dreams. You don't accomplish your goals. That's on you. A woman in America, she can always make an excuse. Oh, I had kids. Oh, I was in an abusive relationship. Oh, I had lost a loved one. Oh, I had got on drugs because this nigga I was fucking with just had me so stressed out and my fucking head was falling. Hey, bitch, I'm just so fucking done. We don't have time for that. As a child, when you want any kid or any minor, when they want to do anything, what do they have to do? They have to ask for permission. They have to ask a parent. They have to ask a guardian. They have to ask a teacher. You know what I'm saying? I ain't never understood that in school. I don't mean to get off subject, but I ain't never understood that in school, how fucking a child got to ask a motherfucker who not even a parent, can they go to the restroom? You understand? Like, that shit. But anyway, not to get off subject, but as a kid, you have to ask for permission for damn near everything. You have to get approval. As a child, you just can't up and move to another state to chase a dream. As a child, you just can't up and, you know, leave any type of situation. Y'all pretty much know what I mean. But as an adult, you don't need no permission. So that's why as an adult, you owe it to yourself. As an adult, you dying if something happened to you. It's sad to say, it's not going to be such a big deal because you're an adult. If you're a child, yeah, it's going to be a worldwide tragedy, pretty much. You know what I'm saying? But as an adult, I mean, it's going to be a tragedy to your family, maybe. Those who care about you, those who love you. You know what I'm saying? But at the end of the day, as an adult, no. You owe it to yourself. That's your fault you didn't get it done.